an episode of Metal Mouth!
That's right, you fucking pussy nut!
Whoa,
can you read the emails?
I don't fucking read no goddamn shit crapping emails. What?
Well, that's the problem. Everyone's saying that you're swearing way too much for the show.
I don't fucking swear that much. You're just a bunch of pussy nuts.
Well, for you guys out there, I'm gonna do this for you guys. I got a little something here. $20 if you don't swear for the whole episode.
Fuck yeah. Yes sir, I accept your offer of services in exchange for a legal tender. All right,
you shook on it.
You see this.
All right, well, we have a great show for you guys out there. And we're gonna have some, the winners for the contest from last week. And we're gonna have another giveaway. And there's tons of really cool news coming up, so.
Stay tuned, because this show is going to functionally rock! Welcome to Metal Mouth News. I'm Sebastian O'Malley.
And I'm Louis-Paul Chiasson.
Our top story today is an Irish group named Gamma Bomb has just released their newest album, available online for free for download. It's called Tales from the Grave in Space, and it's out...
Breaking news. Just hear now that Metal Mouth Media has released their first episode with Blackmore, and supposedly the show was great. Wait, how come I never heard of this before?
Louis, what are you talking about? You were there. We shot it together. Breaking news! Louis-Paul Chiasson's addicted to drugs and alcohol and will be fired from the show soon!
Oh. Breaking news! Sebastian O'Malley's an asshole!
Breaking news! This is awkward.
Suck my balls.
Okay, now Machine Head's frontman, Rob Flynn, just got robbed.
Yes, this is a sad day, man, because they stole a lot of stuff in his house, like cash and computers and wakeboards and wife's jewelry and all kinds of things. But the thing that bothered him the most, they stole 4 guitars, and that two hurts. Of them were really sentimental to him. Like his black Ibanez that he used to record his first album, and the Dimebolt, which was a gift from the late Dimebag Darrell, man. I mean, wow, that's...
That hurts, that's right. And he actually said that he's going to be giving a $1,000 reward for the safe return, no questions asked, of the Black Ibanez, and a $2,000 reward for the safe return of the Dimebag Dimebolt, no questions asked.
Yeah, if anybody stole a guitar that Dimebag gave to me, I'd chop their fucking heads off and put their head on a fucking stick.
Man, you know what I would do if anybody ever stole anything like that
Sebastian,
from me?
What would you do?
I would get a hold of them and I would say, I dislike your unsportsmanlike conduct and I am displeased on multiple levels!
That'll teach them.
I think they'd be hurt.
Yes.
And I was coming back from picking my oldest boy Xander up from school, and that was about 3:00. We walked in here and Xander turned to me and he said, "Hey, Dad, why is the front door open?"
Confused and in shock, East Bay homegrown guitarist Rob Flynn is the victim of a burglary.
And I looked over and I saw a tool set in front of my TV. My TV was out and I was like, what is going on? Like someone working on the house?
Flynn just moved into this home located in the suburbs of Martinez 4 months ago. Taking a break from touring, now he has been hit hard with a break-in.
They hit us hard. I mean, I had 4 guitars stolen. I had both our laptops. I had my Grammy medal.
Sick of you! I'm so sick of you!
That's right, Metal Mouth fans! Gwar is releasing a new album this November, Bloody Pit of Horror.
That's right, and on October 2nd, they're releasing their green jizz all over you with their Bloody Tour of Horror tour.
Yes, and I'll be the first in line to get my ticket, because last time I saw them, it was mayhem, man. It was awesome. I saw like 20 bands last year, from AC/DC to Kiss, everything, but Gwar topped them all. The stage show was a killer, man. It was so crazy. You guys gotta go check them out, man. Don't miss them. You'll regret it. So go check them out. It's Gwar! We'll be right back.
Now, after the death of Terakai's lead guitarist earlier this year, I personally thought it was going to be the end of the group.
Yeah.
But turns out it's not. They just released a new EP called The Last Stand, and I have to say it's really, really well done. I really like it because it's catchy, and they've got fantastic guitar riffs on it, so check it out, you guys.
Different news, I'm going to talk about Lordi. The only reason is the album cover. I mean, check it out. Nice rack. They're also, their new album, they're streaming their whole album on their MySpace, so anybody interested can go check it out. And people that don't know them, here's a quick clip for you guys, right there. Bang Tank!
I am displeased! Okay, so Devil Driver just released part 10 of a 25-part documentary called You May Know Us From the Stage. Now, this documentary has been 8 years in the making. That's quite a long time. Now, Devil Driver, the lead, the front man, used to be... No, not Screwdriver, you fundamentally literate idiot. Devil Driver, stop! Used to be part of Cold Chamber. Now, Cold Chamber and Dez actually split up, and it didn't come down to musical differences, it came down to, basically, drugs. Drugs became more important to the other band members than the music. And so he left Cold Chamber and started Devil Driver. So check out part of the documentary, it's really good. Stop touching yourself! Stop! That's right, you guys, it is contest giveaway time. We got a ton of emails with lots of captions, and they were really funny, you guys. Thank you so much for all the support. But we had to choose a winner, and the winner is Robin from Toronto with her caption, "Watch Metal Mouth, that shit rocks."
Hey, you said shit, buddy.
No, wait a minute, I was quoting what somebody else said, I'm just repeating her words.
Okay, I'll let one slide, that's it.
Okay, so Robin, your Cancer Bat signed CD is in the mail, you should be receiving it shortly. Thanks a lot.
And we have another contest for you guys this week. Thyflesh Consumed gave me their CD a few weeks ago and I had a chance to listen to it. And I must say, these guys eat fucking souls for breakfast. It was really dark, really good, good riffs. Anybody likes death metal, dark metal, this was a really fun ride. We're gonna keep this copy though. And, ooh, yes, but Diminished Fist Record gave us a brand new copy for you guys, and what we want you to do is email us your craziest metal face to metalmouthmedia@gmail.com with your name, address, and your crazy metal face picture. Can you be crazier than this?
Can you be crazier than this?
If you think you can, just send us a picture.
Eh? So Firewind is releasing a new album this October, and guys, I love Firewind because, of course, Gus G.
That's right, and for people who still don't know, Gus G is Ozzy Osbourne's new guitar player, but he also plays for Firewind. And his shredding is just friggin' insane, man. You just gotta check it out, man. He blows my mind, my load, my dad.
My cat.
My mom.
But she's too fat.
Oh!
So they're going on their first North American tour since 2008. So check them out. And for all you crazy fun fanatics, here's a clip. Yeah. Okay, so that's it for episode 2, you guys. Hope you enjoyed it. We had a lot of fun making it. We'd like to thank all the fans for your support, and you know, keep checking us out on YouTube and on Facebook at Metal Mouth Media and metalmouthmedia@gmail.com for any questions or comments.
And we have a few shout-outs for you guys. First, for the girls at Rock Candy for making me rock out with my cock out.
That's
so
right.
Hot. Yeah.
Ooh, nice. And we'd like to thank Diminished Fifth Records for all the free stuff and support they've given us. So thanks a lot, you guys. It was great to have you guys on board.
That's right.
So we now come to the conclusion. Louis, I went through the whole episode. I didn't swear
once. You
sure
did. You did.
I think I deserve a little something.
Like I promise, I'm a man of my word. Here's your $20.
Fuck yeah!
Zoink! F-bomb!
Go!
Well, everybody's heard about the bird. The bird, bird, bird. The bird's a winner.